Well, this big assignment that we had for Dr. Knight's class, we had to take an HCS-104 sensor along with a servo motor, which you can see is under there. It's another little rig, which is pretty cool. I printed this out myself. And we took a choice of either a active or passive or LED light. I chose the passive buzzer just because I thought it would be easier considering this project was not incredibly easy. I have a mess of wires, but like Dr. Knight always says, what matters is the final result. And I did get it working the best possible way that I thought. And I just want to start by showing you that it does work. I'm going to show you that right now. So as you can tell, I plugged it in. I've checked and ran my code. Everything checks out perfectly. Look at that, it's moving. And once it senses something, the passive buzzer should and will go off. See, my mount is working excellent. I had it rigged up with a piece of tape just because I couldn't find screws small enough to fit this hole. But if I do make this design again, I think I can definitely fix that. As you can tell, the servo doesn't have destined spots it turns to. I used a random function, which we described in class, and it worked excellent. This thing just really alternates between values. I use values between, here I have them set to, let's see, random 50 and 150. That's kind of what it alternates between, and it worked great. And this isn't working. So since the object in front, there you go. This is the magazine was in front of it, and it went off. This little buzzer right here is what's making the noise. And because I did use that do while loop, that really helped. The do while loop's purpose, once it goes off, it's a one-time use. In order to reset it, I have to either re-upload the code or I have to unplug it from my computer. But as you can tell, it worked. It was alternating between random values, and it definitely worked very good. I'm going to unplug it, get that annoying passive buzzer to stop, and yeah. So now I'm going to get into more specifics on the code, explain those to you. So, to begin with our code, I just took all the values that I was going to use throughout this. I initialized them. I initialized all my values. In the top, you see I included the SR04 file that Elevu conveniently provided. I also included the servo file, which was already given to me. I didn't really have to do much work for that, which saved a lot of time. Because on this HCS-04 buzzer, there's two different pins. We have the echo pin and the trig pin, as long as the 5-volt pin and the ground pin. I defined those. I defined servo as my servo, which I actually messed up in the beginning. It kept saying I didn't have it initialized in before my setup, so I figured that out, which took me a little bit. I have initialized my long actual, initialized my buzzer as pin 12, which I have on here. 12 goes to my buzzer. And then I have initialized my distance so that my setup and my loop read that and are able to transfer it to the serial monitor. And for my setup, I've already explained my initial values, but for my setup, we have our beginning serial, begin function at 9600, delay of 1000, that's basically how all the codes start off. And then we have my servo attach function, as long as my servo write function. In my servo attach function, I have it hooked up to pin number 7, my Elegoo board. I changed this just for convenience because my board kept getting cluttered with many cables. Then my servo write, it just moves the servo to center position 60 in the beginning. And pin mode buzzer is an output. Pretty much all these codes I took from the files that Elegoo provided. I took segments of those, I put all those in my setup function. And I have my correction factor, the A minus 0.4 divided by 1.2727. That is my correction factor from what we did in class. I might have to change that. Right now, it works fine, but I would like to redo it and try to get a more accurate number, but as of right now, it works. I have my serial print actual value, which, as you can tell from, I initialized up here with my long actual, the way it reads it. Then we have serial print LN, which is just saying that I want my units to be measured in inches. The do while loop that I was able to use that worked really well. The do while loop, the main function of that, and the reason I used it, was because it checks for conditions at the end of the loop, which just means that the statements inside the loop body will be executed at least once, even if the condition isn't true. And that's basically why my buzzer kept going continuously and the servo stopped moving, because the do while loop is a one-time function. Once it completes what you want it to do, it'll just stop. And you have to reset it, which is why it kept going. I explained it in the beginning. So I use the do while loop, and I have a serial begin 9600, delay like I had in my setup, same stuff. My correction factor, I have the distance function, so it'll read as a distance on my serial monitor. I'll show you the serial monitor toward the end. All of these things I literally just took from the files LED provided, and I just put them in here, so it's not super, super complicated. Everything was from that. And for this random servo part, this was a function that we discussed in class. I decided to make my random function go from 50 to 150, which is why this thing alternated between those angles. And this was a lot easier than me putting in, like telling specific parts or angles for the servo to move to. This was so simple. It just really has a mind of its own. It goes where it wants to go. And it made my code a lot easier to understand. I have my serial print random servo just to go with the INT RAN servo. And yeah, that's basically most of the stuff for my do loop. Now let's get into also for the do loop, the while A is greater than 10. The reason I have 10 there in class, I think you said that we had to have it around 25, but I've been using inches for most of my projects just because I like inches. So I converted the number you gave us in class, Dr. Knight, to inches, and that's why I have 10. So basically any value at 10, it'll read that, and that's kind of what it was doing. And for the void loop part, I use my while function, and honestly, I would say a problem I had is I overcomplicated this part. I made the buzzer seem a lot harder than it was, but it was as easy as me just taking the file I would be provided, and I literally just copied and pasted the file they gave us into here. I didn't change anything up, and I did add this while loop, sorry, the while function, which it'll output a frequency from here to here, and it'll make that buzzer go off. The buzzer was by far the easiest part, but I really overcomplicated this, and I learned a lot from this assignment, and I look forward to doing more assignments in the future, and I would say that's a decent overview of my code. I will definitely explain this more in paper for the rest of the assignment. Thank you.